thanks for joining me again. A lot of clients contact us being confused about if they should file a spousal sponsorship application inland or if they should file overseas. Now, I always tell my clients that there's pros and cons for both types of filing, and you can't have your cake and eat it too, unfortunately, when it comes to immigration. There's a lot of benefits to inland, there's a lot of benefits to overseas, and unfortunately both of them also have some cons against them. So each situation is a little bit different, so if you want to know if it's best suited for you to file inland or overseas, perhaps this video will help you make that decision. Whether you file an application inland or overseas, it's not important if you do a spousal application, common law, or conjugal. Obviously, if you're filing a conjugal application, it's because you guys are apart from each other and you cannot be physically together, and that's why you're filing overseas. So when it goes to conjugal, you really don't have much of a choice. It's overseas, and it's because you guys are apart that you're filing a conjugal application. With a common law and spousal, you do get that decision if you want to file inland or overseas. Now, with common law, you do have to be living together for 12 months or more, and it has to be continuous. So if there is a break, it usually is for a vacation or possibly a family emergency. Now, with common law, a lot of people think that once you have the 12 months under your belt, that you could live apart and file an overseas application, and that's not the case. So if you're both you and your partner are outside of Canada, so let's say your partner is a Canadian citizen and you both reside in the United States, then you do have that choice as a common law partner to file overseas. Otherwise, it makes sense to just do the inland application. Now, with spousal, it's a little bit different. There's a lot of inland or overseas applications, and it depends on really what you want to accomplish. And a lot of that decision is really made based on the processing times, based on how long the spousal sponsorship will take to finalize. Now, in regards to what you need to know for inland is the following. So I just made some notes so that you can understand the benefits as well as the cons towards filing an inland application. Now, when you do an inland application, the idea is that you're inside Canada. So the person you're trying to sponsor is physically in Canada and will be with you throughout the process of the application. So the benefit, obviously, is that your spouse, your partner, can be with you throughout the process of the application. The con of the inland is that the processing times usually does take a little bit longer than if you file overseas. Now, again, you have to look at the country of citizenship and see if overseas filing is faster. Sometimes it isn't really necessarily the case. For example, citizens in the Philippines do have an extensive processing time, and inland is a little bit faster than the Philippines, for example. But predominantly, most citizens, like Australia, UK, United States, inland is a little bit longer than overseas. The other benefit for inland application is that your partner can get an open work permit. You can either wait until you get the first stage approved, called approved in principle, to file an open work permit for your partner, or you can, once you submit the spousal sponsorship application inland, with that application, you can include an open work permit as well. Now, the con of the inland or the downside is that you do not have the right to appeal should the application come refused. So let's say you submit the application inland, the application final decision is a refusal, you do not have the right to appeal the application. So many inland individuals either they refile the application or they look at a different avenue to continue their interest for permanent residency. For overseas, obviously, the benefit is that you do have the ability to travel back and forth because, as you know, the inland, you have to physically be inside the country. Now, for inland, just going back on that, once you get that open work permit, travel is still not recommended, but should you travel, it's best that you wait until at least you get the open work permit. When you file an overseas application, you can travel back and forth so long as you have the necessary visa or document to enter Canada. Be careful on how often you travel back and forth, because you want to ensure that the officer understands that despite having a PR application process, your current intent in Canada is temporary. The con of overseas is obviously that you possibly could be apart from your partner for a long time. Most processing times currently are about 12 to 18 months, depending again at what your country of citizenship is. So that means you could be apart for a long time. Now, you could file an overseas application should you have another valid visa document in Canada. So some clients, for example, they are currently on a work permit, they have a valid work permit document in hand, and they're a citizen of the country that processes applications within 6 months, so let's say Australia. They file the application overseas while they're physically in Canada, and that's fine too. Otherwise, if that's not your choice or your situation, then you could be apart from your partner for some time. The benefit of overseas is obviously that you do have the right to appeal should your application be refused when the final decision is rendered. Again, a lot of people, you can watch a video that I've created in regards to should you refile the application or should you go through with the appeal process. Just to reiterate the previous video, most clients do go with the refiling of the application because the appeal process could be tedious and lengthy as well. I hope this video helps in regards to you deciding whether you should file inland or overseas. If you have any questions, we're here to help. Thank you, and until next time.